Hey guys, how are you? I'm very excited about tonight. As you know, I've been working on this Hydrolux foundation for a couple of years, and what I wanted to do was actually show you a live demonstration on myself and why I created this foundation. I'm 54 years old and I have been looking for an alternative to, you know, other things that are out there to make us our skin look younger and smoother. So I created Hydrolux. I took my, you know, I'm a doctor, so I took all of that experience and all that scientific knowledge, as well as my 30 years in the cosmetic industry, and quite personally created this foundation for myself. But I knew that other women had the same issues that I did and really just want smooth, younger looking skin. So this foundation, Hydrolux Foundation, is a first of its kind. It has an ingredient called Smooth Assist in there. This technology of Smooth Assist, instantly when you put it on your skin, creates a smoothing effect, and it gets better throughout the day, which makes it so brilliant. Getting better throughout the day, which means that you put it on, and you know, like a normal foundation, which I'm gonna show you, obviously, I don't have any on yet, but in about 10 minutes, after I'm done my cup of coffee, I go back and I look, and ooh, I look smoother. Guess what, an hour later, I look smoother. So where normal foundations really start to break down, this actually makes the improvement and look of your skin look better. And that's what makes Hydrolux so revolutionary and so different. It's that Smooth Assist technology. And if you stay tuned with me tonight at 11 o'clock in Sean's Beauty Secrets live from NYC, yay, I'm even going to show you that this has been clinically tested. We have broken the barrier in the world of foundation, because we've done testing and different things that foundations never have. You will see clinical before and afters of instant immediate results and 4-week term results, which makes it even more brilliant. Most of the time, most of these women, like 97% of the people after 4 weeks, said their pores look smaller. That majority of women said that they love their skin without foundation on. And that's what makes this foundation so revolutionary. If you ask any women out there, what do they really want from foundation? And we asked, trust me, and I am one of those women. We just want our skin to look smooth and evened out. So those fine lines, those wrinkles, the uneven skin tone, you know, the rosacea, maybe melasma, I have age spots, freckles. We want smooth, even looking skin, and just with the foundation, you're getting long-term benefits, which really, quite honestly, some of the benefits that you're seeing in this foundation, you don't even see in regular skincare.
Hi, so, addicts. Hi, Ashley and Diane.
Hey, guys. How are you?
Some of the addicts. Tina's here.
Hi, Tina. How are you?
Are you guys excited for the launch on QVC tonight? I think they are.
Yeah, I'm excited Yeah, I can't wait. I'm really excited. But before I took a shower and did my hair and everything, I wanted to show everybody, because I wanted to show you real time what this foundation can do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start. So I wear Shade Light. We are going to post throughout the day shades. And let me talk about that really quick before I show you this. People always want to know shades. Most of the time, it's interesting that women don't know what shade they are. Not what shade to buy, but they just don't know what shade they are. So I was trying to think, how do I make it easy for you to know, are you a fair? Are you a light? Are you a light medium? Are you a medium? Are you a tan? Are you a deep? What shade am I? And unless you go to a department store and swipe it down your neck, you kind of don't know what that range is. So let me tell you that fair women, you are very porcelain skin. You have some freckles. You never, ever, ever get a suntan. You always burn. Your skin looks a little pink. That would be somebody, that means that you are actually a fair shade. So let's go to light. I'm light. I have some pink. I have some redness. I have freckles. I will always sunburn. That sunburn eventually turns into a tan if I don't burn and peel first. But I never get that rich, golden, gorgeous tan, but I can get a little bit of color. I'm going to go for shade light.
We have some UK gals asking.
Oh, hey, my UK girls, listen.
They tell them what they're getting and when they're getting it.
Yeah, I'm really excited, guys. This is kicking off as today's special value with you guys on September 19th. I am beyond thrilled. And if you're just jumping in and joining me, I'm going to tell you just a recap really quick of why I created this foundation. Like I said, I'm 54 years old and I was looking for alternatives other than doing procedures and stuff like that. Not that there's anything wrong with it, but something that instantly smoothed my skin. So this has a clinical active in it. It's a high performance active called Smooth Assist. And what it does is when you put it on your skin, once this foundation sets, it starts to smooth the skin. To be a little bit more technical, it kind of works on the contractures, much like if you were to get an injectable, which is much more severe, like doesn't allow the muscle to move. This just relaxes all of those fine lines and instantly smooths out the skin. This has never been done in a foundation before. I took those 30 years in the beauty experience. I took my doctor expertise and all of that scientific knowledge, blended those two bad boys together, and what I came up with is a foundation that really, honestly, it's gonna rival any other foundation that's out there. So let me kind of get back to the shade. So I'm in shade light. I have a little pink, I have a little bit of yellow, and I go a little bit more towards a neutral tone. I burn before I tan. I tan eventually, you know, after that sunburn starts to fade, I get a little tan, but I never get that rich. So that, if you kind of fall into that category, you're gonna go for shade light. So when you're looking in the mirror, if you're a little warmer than me, okay, which means that you're heading more towards a medium shade, which is that kind of that richer shade. That means you can go out in the sun. You can have a good time in the sun, which you know you should wear SPF. And for my girls, wait a minute, for my girls in the UK, you know that you should be wearing UltraSun. And for my girls in the US, you should be using Dr. Danesse's 50 plus SPF. You know SPF is... If you're a little bit warmer than me, and you can kind of see my skin tone, a little bit warmer than me, heading more towards that kind of tan range, you would fall in that light medium, and that's the shade that's a little bit warmer than me. So medium is when everyone says medium's your most popular shade. When you look in the mirror, you have a bit of a yellow undertone, and people are like, I don't even know what my undertone is. But let's talk about who a medium is. She's the type of girl that goes out, she's in the sun, you know, when you were younger, we didn't know about SPF, and you got this beautiful golden rich tan very easily. She's kind of the girl that we envied. She got this beautiful rich tan. She's a little bit more yellow in the skin tone, definitely never gonna be a pinky girl. You're gonna be medium. So, that's how, like, when you look in the mirror, this is how we say, okay, is it like what Dars described? Are these the shades that I am? Then we go to tan. She definitely, when you look at her, she's got that olive skin tone. She's got that Mediterranean skin tone. She looks like she's been in the sun, and she's naturally that rich. Tan's typically more of a yellow undertone. So, like I said, undertones are weird. You know, sometimes you don't even know what color undertone you are. But just go with how I am when I'm explaining it to you. She's more olivey. You know, she has kind of, I would say, even maybe a little bit more of a gray color to her skin without makeup on. That's going to be your tan. Then we go into deep shades. Deep shades can be a little tricky, and all of my deep gals out there know that, because you can be either a little yellow or you can be red. You have about 15 different shades in between for my little deep girls. So what we did with Hydralux is we put it more towards the yellow so it doesn't go ashy and it doesn't create too much red. If I would have done red, you know, on top of it, doesn't look good. So the yellow is gonna counteract that ashiness, and also it's gonna counteract that red, and it's gonna create more of a neutral undertone. So,
and everybody can head over to Facebook and we put our gorgeous QVC models.
Yeah, we put the swatches up there. So when you see the swatches, interesting enough.
Ellen's in here too. She's one of our girls. She's like,
hey.
Hey, Ellen.
Hey, Ellie Ellers. So when you look at those girls, pay more attention, because a lot of times people look and say, well, I don't have brown hair, but I have her skin tone, or I don't have, brown hair. My hair isn't red like Elle. But what you want to do is just really kind of look at the way their skin looks and kind of match it. And that way you can understand, like, what is really my shade? And once you fall in shade, as cosmetic manufacturers, we kind of create those colors in accordance with those shades. So I think it's really important first for you to establish actually what shade you are. And if you have further questions on that, I'm going to do a video on shades, on how to create, you know, how to really figure out what tone you are. And we'll keep that because I do find that people have a difficulty in. They'll say, what's your shade? And they'll go, I'm light. And I look at them and go, you're clearly medium. Or they'll go, I'm medium. I'm like, you're clearly tan or you're clearly light. So once you've established that, then you can kind of pick off of cosmetic ranges and say, and we know how to do that as manufacturers to stay in those ranges that fit your skin tone.
Anita missed the beginning of the live stream. Would you mind repeating what would be good for olive undertones?
Okay, olive. So when you have olive skin tone, you notice your olive, you can be slightly a little bit gray when you look in the mirror. So what you wanna do, our tan has more of a yellow undertone to it. It's gonna even out any redness and it's gonna brighten and neutralize that skin tone.
And don't worry, Anita, we will share this on Facebook at the end so you can watch from the very beginning.
Yeah. So, but any questions? But what I want to do is I want to show you this bad boy.
Congratulations, everybody. They ordered it already.
Yeah, that, first of all, you guys, you almost crashed my website. My little girl, Mo, that works on the website, she's like, oh my gosh, it's crashing. The amount of excitement that happened with it. I'm really so proud of this foundation, and thank you so much for supporting me. I create this brand really from my heart. And like I said, you know, I took all that experience, you know, as a doctor and I've been in the beauty industry for 30 years. And I just married those two together to create really a foundation that I knew every woman looked for, no matter what her age was. We all have the same issues. So whether, you know, you're in your late 20s, your early 30s, you're me, you're 54, you're my mom's 74, it doesn't matter. We all want smooth, instantly smooth looking skin. And for the first time, a foundation will instantly smooth the skin.
Is a light medium shade a yellow or neutral undertone?
Neutral.
It's neutral.
Yeah, neutral.
Tara. And thank you, everybody. We're so excited about our launch. We appreciate all of your love and support. We love you, too.
Yeah. I love you guys. I adore you guys. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get started, and I'm going to show you the coverage, and I really want to show you the texture. So it's a liquidy texture, and it comes with this, like, amazing killer brush. You know I do some of the best brushes. You know how I feel about brushes. They're really important. These are extensions of your fingers, but they also apply product better than your fingers can. Don't use your fingers because you have natural dirt and oil on your fingers and it breaks your any makeup down. Plus, it's the difference between a Picasso and a finger paint. You know how I always say that. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you really close. See these kind of wrinkly parts that I have underneath my eye? This is called, these are fine lines and wrinkles, obviously. I've earned them. And then I have what they call cross-hatching.
Janice, she doesn't have Botox. She's using our Hydralux.
Yeah. Let me tell you something. I'm not against Botox. I'm not. And I'm going to tell you the very last time that I did have Botox, you know me, I'm honest, because my mom tells me once you start lying, you got to remember all the lies, was before my son's wedding in September of last year. I wanted to look good for the wedding. Not even gonna lie. And so I have been using this foundation and working on Smooth Assist since. Now, and I'm gonna show you something, so you got really close. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put these where these lines are, and I'm gonna show you, look how easy this coverage is, okay? See how it instantly covers, how super ridiculously thin it is? So I'm gonna put it all up on these lines, and I'm gonna do half my face, and then watch once it starts to dry. So ready, I'm gonna do just half my face. It's covered.
That brush is incredible.
Yeah, the brush is like, listen, if you don't like this kind of brush, use it to like paint something with. It's like the most amazing brush. Mm-hmm. So what I'm gonna do is half of this bad boy.
Wow.
Now,
Doris, can you explain to the women who are already hydrogel lovers the difference between the shades?
So the shades in Hydralux are a tad bit warmer than hydrogel. It's also a very different texture.
Wow, I wish you could do this on QVC because that is It's
insane. Now, what I want you to do, you have to give me, I know Facebook Live, people don't like to spend a lot of time waiting, but what I want you to do is it needs to dry. So because Smooth Assist takes a moment, and what it does, when you get this home and you put this on, it's not gonna go poof instantly like that. You're gonna put it on like you do your normal stuff, get ready, then look back in the mirror in 10 minutes. I won't make you wait 10 minutes because it starts to actually work. But you'll notice in about 10 minutes, all of these fine lines, it's so funny because a lot of girls might ask, like, oh, Dar's skin looks so good. What did you do? What did you do? And it's really, bottom of my heart, all I've been doing is Hydralux. And it's the Smooth Assist technology that makes it so unbelievably brilliant. It smooths out lines and wrinkles. It smooths out uneven skin tone.
Can I tell you what it does for me? I'm 28 and I don't have a lot of wrinkles, obviously, right now.
It's starting to work.
My dark circles, which is hereditary, I've been wearing this now for how long, you think?
We've been working on this for about 3 years. We did all the clinicals and all that other stuff.
But from wearing it at age 28 with my dark circles, I've noticed the darkness and redness has lightened.
Yeah, and it does do that because it has, not only does it have the Smooth Assist, it has, at an active level, it has all of these other clinical benefits. So now what I'm going to do is...
We have some questions. Sorry to interrupt really quick. Jody, she wants to know if you make an oil-free foundation. Would you point her towards this? Because I feel like...
So first of all, my question is to you, why are you looking for an oil-free foundation?
Okay, let's see what Jody replies with. And is this foundation good for acne prone skin?
Absolutely, absolutely. But now listen to me. If you're the type of person, and I will tell anybody that has any kind of skin issues or difficulties with their skin, you should always do a patch test. So a patch test, just put it on the side of your cheek, see if you get any kind of reaction to it, whether it's from $10, drugstore, wherever.
Just sitting here. Sorry, I'm sitting behind the camera looking at this powerful. Look at that. Doris is just like us. She has her redness, her discoloration, some freckles.
See?
Look at that.
You saw how easy. I didn't have to stipple. I didn't have to do anything. But see, now, the interesting thing is, in an hour, this stuff's going to look even smoother. So see the difference? See how I have the cross-hatching? Lines and wrinkles, any other foundation in the world, when you have this kind of wrinkly stuff like this, it creases, it cracks, it doesn't smooth. So what do? You have to put a primer on it. You're trying to even it out. Don't put a primer on before this foundation. You want that Smooth Assist right up against that skin. See it? See it working? I love it on my neck. So my neck is one of my problem areas. It's one of the areas I hate the worst.
Doris applied the light guy. She's light and Hydralux.
Yeah.
And if you usually use light and hydrogel,
Stay with light. Yeah. It's definitely a little bit warmer, but it's okay. It's staying within those shade ranges. Now, I want to show you something really cool. So one of the problems I really hated, you know, as a woman, listen, we all have things that we don't love about ourselves, and that's why makeup is there. That's why it's the beauty of being a girl, and it's the beauty of having makeup. But I had a rare, rare form of thyroid cancer called Herthal cell carcinoma. It's really what prompted me to create this brand, because with Herthal cell carcinoma, it actually usually happens in the elderly. I always, you know, things happen with me that are always never normal. But I lost my brows. I'm left with this type of swelling, rosacea.
Congratulations, Pia. You just ordered it.
It's so good. I swear to you. I mean, I'm like flabbergasted. Now, all right, so now it's been, what, maybe 4 minutes? I don't know. But I'm going to come in really close.
Look at that. Tara wants to know, when you say the difference between the two foundations more warmer, is it more yellow when you say warmer?
Definitely when we talk about warmer, it's definitely, all right, now interesting. You really want yellow in your foundation. And most people go, oh, that's too yellow for me. Put it on your skin, and I'm gonna tell you why it's really, really important for the yellow in your foundation. Yellow neutralizes red. 99% of the time, if you're putting on foundation, you want to even something out. You're going to cover something. You want smoother looking skin. And there is a massive majority of us that have redness in our skin. If you put pink on top of pink, if you put red on top of red, it just makes you look more red. So what you need to do is you want to neutralize those, and what neutralizes red is yellow. So when you look at it, you swatch it on your hand, like a lot of people do this. So this, it's an interesting concept. They swatch it on their arm and they go, oh, this is yellow. Well, this right here isn't red. This right here is red. So that's what you want to neutralize. What you see on your face, people go, oh, try it on your wrist. Not the same color, guys. Look, look at, this is, all right, this is really cool to show you. This is, I'm a light. People would normally say swatch it on your wrist. Look at the difference between how my wrist looks and how my face looks. See how much warmer it is and see the red? If I put red on top of this, I would look like an apple. So you don't want to do that. All right, has it been 5 minutes
Hey,
now?
Nikki, Nikki Chavez is here.
Nikki, beer time. Let's pop some bottles. All right, so what I want to show you is, ready? It's been about 5 minutes. So I'm going to go in really ridiculously close. So this is with the smooth assist on this side. See those lines, how they're starting to diminish? And I'm telling you, after an hour, it's like really cool. See how everything's covered, ooh, all of my freckles,
and
all of my eyes,
and look at this side. From this side.
See that? See the cross hatching? This is on both sides. Look right here. It's not there. Can you see? That's why I'm like flipping my lid, popping beers with Nikki over this foundation.
Is light medium
a little warmer?
A lot lighter than medium and hydrogel?
No. Is light medium a lot lighter than medium and hydrogel? It ranges right between light and medium. So so can you see? All right, now let's talk about my neck.
Does this make your face feel tight?
No.
Everyone wants to know.
That's funny because you know what? One of the makeup artists that we did that big launch in New York City, she called me, she goes, I'm not feeling any tightening in my face. I don't want, this isn't that stuff. Do you remember that stuff years ago? And it is still around, and you put it on your face, and it did this. And you couldn't do anything with it, because if you did that, it would crack. It felt like that. No, it just, it doesn't feel like anything. It's just your foundation. As a matter of fact, in all the consumer panel studies, the women love the way their skin felt. And I have all the statistics, all the clinical data, all the clinical information. We have been working on this for a really long time. This has clinically active levels of smooth assist, which means that it just relaxes. Tell me that's not smooth. So people go, she has Botox. No, I don't. And I don't do lip injections either. My face is chunky. I've gained about 25 pounds since my son's wedding.
You still look beautiful.
Because you all know I'm a pizza girl. Eating pizza.
Don't
I like
worry,
to eat.
Everybody will get a TSV.
Yeah, and here's the other thing. My new latest obsession, and it's killing me, is caramel M&Ms.
Oh, mine too.
I am obsessed with caramel M&Ms.
Maureen, a little bit goes a long way. Trust
so,
me.
So yeah, a tiny bit. But now let me show you something really exciting, because here's another area that I, one of my most troublesome areas. Of course, I can say I'm 54. I've got those problems.
Put it on your lids. Yeah.
You can use it as eyeliner base to smooth that out. That's really good. But what I want to show you is my neck. Okay. I had my thyroid removed. So with my thyroid removed, I've lost that mass, which means that I don't want to talk in doctor terms, but it's tissue. And tissue creates fullness. And when I had all of that removed through here, I lost all of that fullness. Kind of like your boobs fill out your shirt. It's like, you know, I lost that. So this is an area that's just kind of very saggy for me. Of course, with my age, it naturally comes, but I don't have anything to fill this out. So when I use that, see the difference? I put it right down here on the side of my neck. Mm-hmm. See how this smooths that out? Now, look, it's not gonna, you know, it's not, this is like an iron. It's gonna iron away. Can you see now? This is about 10 minutes.
Doris, if somebody wears medium in hydrogel, should they
medium.
Go?
Medium.
They should go for the medium or the light medium?
Medium. Oh, is hydrogel a good shade for you in medium?
All right, let's wait to see. Jackie, let us know if medium is a great shade in hydrogel for you, and we will direct you to the correct color in Hydrolux.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's coming to the UK on September 19th.
TSV! Look, all right, wait. I want you guys to really see how insane this is. Okay, ready? I'm gonna get super close.
Look at the smoothness.
This is wow. Instant. I just put on a foundation. All right, now here's the other side.
Aww.
See, this is what I got.
You're just like us, stars.
Yeah, and that's why I did it. Listen, like I said, I was looking at 54 years old. What could I create? Because I can create anything. What could I create, honestly, that every woman, it would be just a game changer for every woman, and more importantly, not to be selfish, but a game changer for myself. And that's what it did. I mean, look at my skin. Like, throw your filters away. I gotta get so super close, because this is, every time I say this, and an hour later, it's gonna be even better. Like, really, see? Look at that. Can you see how smooth it is? Look how everything's covered.
And she, Doris isn't wearing her glasses, so it may not be blended perfectly.
Oh, is that what it is? Because I don't have my glasses on. Wait, but is it not blended perfectly? You should have told me.
It's blended, well, I'm proud of you. For not wearing your glasses and the way that you wear.
You know, I got glasses. I can't wear them on air because let me see. Isn't that blended really good?
It's blended well. Just a little bit of maybe. I always like to take my foundation a little bit towards my ear as well.
Oh, I didn't. Okay, yeah, here. Well, yeah. I just wanted to show you around where the lines were. Also,
fair look. Is the fairest of all, Michelle.
Yeah.
But we're gonna repost this so you'll be able to see Dara's chat from the very beginning. And she discusses all of the shades.
Yeah. Look at my nasolabial folds. Is that killer?
Yes, it
Tell
is.
Tell it's like amazing. It's like, I don't know. This is like, if I'm gonna have to do like a vat size for my thighs, for my stomach. Like, but all right, so.
It does not have sunscreen in it.
No, it doesn't have sunscreen in it, okay? I'm gonna put this on and I'm gonna blend everything. It doesn't, all right, so let me tell you a little bit of something about sunscreen. So now that we're talking, and I love that I can talk on Facebook where I'm not like governed and say, anything with pigment in it has a natural sunscreen in it, okay? So sunscreen has been come under like, it's now come under the what they call an OTC, which means it's an over-the-counter drug.
Oh, wait, really quick. Tina, unfortunately, it's not up to us whether it's a TSV or not. We would give it as a TSV to every country
I would.
We could. Trust us.
So, and honestly, I really would. There, some of these decisions aren't mine. But I will tell you that I did something really special for everybody for the launch of this. You are getting the brush, basically for free with the foundation tonight for the launch. So that's there. There's only so many things that I personally can control. It's really not up to me.
Hi, Lisa.
All right. So what is it about? How long is it now? About 12 minutes?
Sure, but you got a lot of people tuning in. Look at that.
Can you see it?
All right, so there's this new assist, Hydro Love Foundation, and there's what Doris.
Look.
I so wish that you could show this live on air, because you're before.
It's crazy, right?
Yes.
See how smooth my skin is? Listen, it's the number one thing that we as women want to have a foundation is smooth skin.
Yep.
So I always, like, my whole ethos of this brand is, I knew I could steal 10 minutes of your day. Every woman has 10 minutes. I don't care what it is. 10 minutes out of your day. If I had those 10 minutes, I would get you dialed up and out the door and looking and feeling your best. And that's really what I do. I try to create products that are simple, easy, effective. We use these high performance actives, you know, at clinical levels that really seriously, guys, I wanted to do it live because you know I'm only have about 8 or 9 minutes tonight. You're not going to be able to see it, so I really wanted you to see.
That's okay, Tina. We know. We just want you to know that we don't have full control of that, or else we'd give it to all
of
you.
It's crazy.
And Jackie actually answered, and she is a medium in the hydrogel.
So go with medium, babe. Medium.
Okay.
Yeah. Stay true to your hydrogel colors. Stay true to them. They are a tad bit warmer, but my hydrogel always ran a little on the lighter side. So these are gonna be a little bit even more truer for you. But is it?
Hi, Nick, love you.
Nikki.
He said hello, Caitlin.
Nikki, my boy. I love my Nikki.
Sheree, you're gonna love this. If you love hydrogel, it I mean,
there's nothing like it.
There's nothing like this on the market.
That's why it was picked to launch in Sean's show in New York. Everybody that's seen this so far behind the scenes, and that's kind of how this works. Like when we create things, you know, the people at QVC and stuff like that, and they've seen it, and everyone goes, they just went crazy.
So we have a few questions.
Sure, I love it.
What do you use as a setting powder over this foundation?
You don't have to set.
But if you wanted to,
anything.
CC powder would be great.
CC powder would be great. Yeah, CC powder is great. Finishing powder is great. We have both of those on doll10.com. But whatever, you know, if you like to set your foundation, but you don't have to, because what I'm going to come in close again. I want you to see the finish.
Carrie, you can use any concealer with this.
Yeah, I use this right up as a concealer. Did you see? This is what I did. I put up underneath my eye.
You really don't need a ton of concealer, but what I will let you know is that we might have a little BFF coming along with this soon.
Yeah, it's coming this spring.
Woohoo! And but, Nick said, we are on at 11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time tonight, and we're in getting ready for New York Fashion Week. We're in Sean's Beauty Secret Show live from New York.
Guys, isn't this crazy?
Like, how long should this set before applying on top, as in blush, concealer, Tina?
Oh, it sets immediately with your skin. There's nothing worse than I hate what we call as lag time in foundation. If you're sitting there and that stuff is like an oil slick on your face, you have the wrong foundation. That foundation, one of the things that I'm a stickler about is that it sets with the skin. Because I know as a woman, I got 10 minutes. I can give you 10 minutes. That's about it. If I got to wait 10 minutes for my foundation to dry, I'm not getting the rest of it done. So.
Yes, Roxy, if you mix medium and tan and hydrogel, the medium would be a perfect match for you, I think.
Yeah.
What do you think, Darcy?
Yeah, do you... Hang on a second. Mo, do you want to go grab all the shades?
Sure.
I'll pump all the shades out for you.
Yeah.
Guys, if I'm not blowing your mind right now, it blows my mind because I look and I go, this literally looks like a younger version of myself.
Is sunscreen going to disrupt the skincare properties of this foundation, Alyssa wants to know?
No, sunscreen won't, but this is what I want you to do. You know, there's two things that you can do with, I'm a huge, huge firm believer in SPF, and one of the things with SPF that I'm a stickler about is that most of the damage that's done to the skin and the aging process is done from the sun. So, I mean, back in the day, I used to lay on a foil blanket and used to take baby oil and iodine and mix it up and lather myself till I would blister. Sometimes I would take the blister as I was laying out and pop the blisters and peel the skin.
Oh,
I mean, that's what we did. And it sounds gross, but back in the day, that's what we did. We weren't educated on really what happened and what's going on with the sun. So, yes, SPF is really good. You can use your SPF. Most of the time, your facial moisturizers all have an SPF. You don't need a double SPF, so everybody puts a moisturizer on. Put your moisturizer on in the morning and then get ready. It won't disrupt it, which is perfect.
Oh my God. Jane says 1980 tanning blanket.
Do you know what? Remember? It's now they call them, they're like those things that you put in your car on the
to protect
the sun. Remember they're those silver things, and now you put them on the thing, and that's what I laid
on.
So
we are going to post this, share it onto our Facebook page for anybody who missed it. We're very quickly gonna go over the
real
shades.
Quick. All I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a pump of each one so you can see.
And then remember to tune in tonight at 11 p.m. at QVC. Dars will be, and we're already at limited quantity, so Dars will be presenting this, and you'll have this to come back to look at all the shades.
All right, hang on. Here's your light medium.
Going down the line, it's going to be fair, light, light medium. Now she's going to put a little from the medium.
Hang on.
Thank you, Bella. Yes, windshield.
There's a medium.
Congrats, Anita. So, starting from the top, it's fair, light, light medium, tan, medium, tan, and deep. Love you too, Adrian.
Ready?
fair.
So do you see? She put light, the littlest bit.
Light, medium. Goes,
that's even a lot.
Medium. Tan.
Look, she's trying to. You can't, I know it looks.
I don't know how good that is, but we'll do a proper shade matching just before I sign up. Because I have to go take a shower and do my hair.
We will have a picture on Facebook of the swatches. Don't you worry. We know that that's your biggest, you know, choice. So we'll make sure to let you know all the shades. And thank you guys. We're so excited.
All right, guys, love you. I'll see you tonight, okay? I gotta wash my hair and catch the train.
But first, she has to finish the other side of her face.
I'm gonna go like this. This side I'll get carded, and this side I won't.
We'll see you tonight at 11 p.m. QVC. Tune in Eastern Standard Time. Love you guys. Thank you for watching.